you know, I think girls, we do this, right? We start planning very early about getting married or having children. You know, I was one of those tomboys that my father very cleverly put into a lot of physical activities morning to night, so I would never even think of doing something naughty. Having said that, I did kiss my first boy when I was 8. He had no idea. But I didn't even know what a period meant until I had it, right? But while these girls were talking about babies and husbands and everything else, I was sitting and rehearsing Grammy speeches and pretending to be Michael Jackson and Madonna and everything else. Anyway, so the concept of a marriage or a child didn't exist. Straight A student, both parents, doctors, Armed Forces Medical College, Army, all over the place, 2 years in Bhutan, you know, everywhere else. 31st December, Manasi, she pronounced it right, means the ideal woman. Like, that's the kind of power my parents gave me. Discs, double income, single kids. They wanted to protect the environment from the get-go. So you become a straight-A student, you grow up, you have boyfriends, very open family. Never even thought about marriage until, of course, I met my ex-husband. While it was incredible that I was married to him, I changed my wedding date 10 times because I wanted to shoot in Japan until my father actually used very abusive language with me and said, "This is not a joke. You can't do this to a marriage." I said, "Fine, let's get married, no problem." Until those vows happened in church, because he was Christian, I didn't realize what I was getting into, because it was, you know, sanctification before God. And for the longest time, quickly in a nutshell, I was in an extremely abusive relationship. 8 out of the 9 years that I was married never worked. And in the middle of all that, a person who never wanted to have a child was told to have a child while my career took off. Naturally, released in 2005, we were doing a world tour. And this guy, who was a complete wastrel, actually told me, "You know, give me a child because then I'll be able to, you know, be a stay-at-home father." I said, "Wow, I'm going to save this man." So I get pregnant. My mother, very clever person, I wish I had her brains. She just went, "Who is going to earn the money?" Anyway, dad was happy. Child happened. Baby happened. And I was literally singing till my 8th month, almost like a single mom even then. Got back onto stage at 29 days after my little kid was born. And, you know, thank you. 12 kilos overweight with all that. And I realized the love and respect the industry gave me. And for the first time, and this is what the books and the movies and everybody has got spot on and correct, and you mothers will know, childbirth is the single most emotional experience, the most incredible. It's like you know, being born again, literally. So this was my mother. She's got a hospital. My dad was a pediatric surgeon in the army, but my mom's in Civvy Street. And I had decided, listening to all my friends who had kids, dude, this labor pain business, is I can't handle it. So my code word for mother was Caesar. If I say it, take me to cesarean section, okay? So unfortunately, we had some complications with this little guy in my stomach. I had an army, you know, strong warrior what do they call, gynecologist, who refused to deliver my baby because I wanted to sing in my 9th month as well. But then I stopped and then I said, okay, fine, I'll deliver a baby. We had complications. We went in for a cesarean section. I had this anesthetist who literally described it like you would see in a movie or a book, or read it in a book about, you know, how your heart is being ripped out of your body and you're crying unconditionally. So that all happened. A person who didn't know ABCD of motherhood saw this, instinctively waited for this child to cry. And I realized that my life had changed forever. Never watched football, I'm a cricket fan. So when he was born, the name that we gave him was Zifan. Zifan means treasured by God. But he's called Zizou, because when I was pregnant, it's the year I watched Zinedine Zidane in action, headbutt people and go, that's my kid, you know. And Shruti, we have a common friend who's also Zizou. Maria has been my angel through my entire pregnancy. Anyway, this child arrived. So until then, I have to tell you, I'm a software engineer. I did a postgrad in film and television production. Was dissuaded from doing medicine. Had a call letter for the Indian Air Force because I wanted to be the female Top Gun. When this child happened, and I'd been singing, by the by, because dad was a drummer surgeon and he wanted to live vicariously through me and said, please become a singer. You know, for my sake, just do this. So I said, okay, theek hai, I've got these... you posted a status, right? Surf Excel, the Surf Excel thing. This was dad, who's no more, his takya kalam. Do whatever you want to do in life. Surf Excel hai na, I'll take care of you. Having said all that, being raised like that, army brat, going through abuse, you know, I don't know, it's something I can talk about now without crying. It's you know, it's something that happens to you. And it took me, a child, to be born into my life for two very brave decisions. He was 2, I think, yeah, 2. I was lucky I got out early when I just looked at him and he'd come very instinctively to come and stand between me and my ex-husband. And I just said, no, 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 my kid ain't growing up like that. Military precision after that, divorced my husband. Luckily, I was a bread earner because, you know, my husband wasn't earning. But still, that whole you know, stigma. And dad was in line to become Director General Medical Services. And you know how it is in India, there's like stigma attached, sikni mom, tambram father. So my discussion with my parents was literally, I hope it's not going to mess with your careers, but I'm getting a divorce. These are my parents who opened a bottle of champagne and said, you've come to your senses. So, And this is, you know, I wish Eat, Pray, Love had released, or the book had come out before I got pregnant, because there's that line, be very sure that you want to have a child, it's like getting a tattoo across your forehead. Had I known that, I would have, you know, never done it, but no, Zafan, anytime, I would have done it 20 times over again. But, so there I am, trying to get this divorce through, and my child, my big strength, I was willing to give it all, then I fought for him. All this time, singing, acting, doing everything else, and you know, I think when you're, even though you're raised this powerful, black belt in karate, 12 horse rider, national level, you know, basketball player, climbed many mountains, still, sometimes when you're that strong, you try to make a bad thing work for too long, and it takes a child to come into your life to tell you, no, mama, this ain't cool stuff. So I was lucky; I had an outlet with music. I had my kid. Got out of it, bad story, done, finished. Now I'll come to the story, is the only story that I've prepared about my kid. So I don't know how many of you are single moms, I don't know how many of you are grappling with getting a divorce, I don't know how many of you are. I work with some groups where I tell women a simple thing. Women empower or put women down. Look around you, if you've got women around you that you know are going through something, and this happened to me from a complete stranger who deals with kids and autism. I'm going to speak very fast because I don't know how much time I have. Okay, we can. So, out of the blue in my building when I was going through the divorce, and I'm in a really nice building, nice people, you know, upper middle class. And there is that look that you get that you're divorced, and my maid would try to tell my kid to lie to everybody. And I was like, no, he will tell people he's mum's divorced. We went with that. And, you know, at that point in time, trying to figure out society, people, everything else, this one lady I'd never met, she was the daughter of one of my neighbors, walked up to me, held my hand. Don't ask me how I know, but I know you were being abused. I'm so glad you're out of it because your child is blossoming. I didn't know that when my child would go down, he'd be great in the house, but he'd be an extremely angry, aggressive child who wouldn't interact with other people, who wouldn't talk to other people, who, you know, it was like the biggest pat on my back. Moved out of that, got him into Besant Montessori. The fighting continued. Now I'm getting to my story, Layal, that I prepared yesterday. So from the time that he was 2.5 years old till he got a little older, when I was called to the principal's office, it's like being back in the principal's office as a kid. I would stand like shivering outside, your son has done this today, he hit that guy today. And this is carried on for whatever, second standard to fifth standard, that's Besant Montessori. One day he tried to kiss someone, one day he tried to hit someone, one day he tried to say, I'm too intelligent, I don't want to study. So all this has happened. All the time, by the way, he also picked up football from YouTube and he's taken two teams to national victories. So that's my kid. So cut to, I decided, army brat, 9 schools and colleges, what's the next best thing? And I reached out to a lot of friends and a lot of people who've been in boarding schools. And this is for mums who've got kids who are boys. Boarding school is extremely traumatic for men. So when you're, you know, somebody was talking about therapy and everything else, there are a lot of help areas around. I think it's like a mummy complex. It's like, you know, the boys want to be mama's boys, girls want to be daddy's girls. It's like, I don't know, something about mom sending kids to boarding is like, you've abandoned me, I'm not your child. It's that kind of a syndrome. So go through it, chat with your children, be honest about it. Anyway, I went through everything, Lovedale, Mayo, I had seats everywhere. And literally at a party, and I'm a crazy person, I'm very impulsive. At a party, a Parsi person has walked up to me and spoken to me about a Parsi school in Nasik called Flavashi International Academy. It's 40 acres of bliss. It's the best thing you'll do for your child. That I've said, that's it. This is God sent. It's come to me. And he goes into a school and he's flourishing. He's won victory. All this has happened and mom's really proud. And I get a call. Come to the principal's office. And I've gone, ayo, what am I going to do? Okay, now I'm not going to try and cry. So I get to the principal's office and I'm shaking, shivering outside and I'm like, what is my son done now? I said, I'm so sorry. I know he's like a very physically active child. You know, he's a bad marriage and everything. She said, no. I wanted to tell you that I've never met a single child at the age of 9 that is this respectful towards women, stands up for other women and writes his first essay about how proud he is of his mom. So that's my story. It's all scattered and everywhere, but thank you so much for having me here today. He's the single most incredible person in my life. He taught me to let go of fear, sing for the love of it, do whatever I want to do. He even tells me if I'm not looking good in a shirt. He says, Mom, it's not working. Today I said, I'm talking about you. So he goes, who's going to be there? And I said, that's it. Anytime I've taken to Goa, he literally asks about the party guy in Goa and said, can we go to his house? So I don't know if I'm raising right or wrong, but as long as he is proud of me as a mom, I think I'm doing a good job. And as long as he's treating women right, I think he's doing a good job. Thank you.